Howdy and welcome. Thanks for joining us today for our Master of International Policy and DC Degrees overview. This is the fourth webinar that we are presenting this fall in a series. We still have a few more upcoming that will cover our student resources and what it's like to be a student here. We have others coming up for admissions, career services, and financial aid. So be sure to join us later. We're going to give an overview about some of those aspects in today's webinar specific to these MIP here in College Station and the ones in DC, as well as a lot more detail in those unique webinars. So once again, this is an interactive one, if we can make it that way. If you guys have any questions for us during this presentation, be sure to jot those down and put them into the chat function, and Joseph and I will try to take some time to answer those as we go along. So the presenters today, it's me, I'm Catherine Meyer, Director of Admissions and Recruitment here at the College Station campus at the Bush School. I've been here almost 20 years now, watching this program grow and expand, and I'm excited today to have Joseph join us from the DC location. He will take over in the last half of this presentation. So I've got an agenda here that's going to have us starting with the College Station campus with our MIP. And then we'll have Joseph take over and talk about the DC degrees. So I'm going to start with talking a little bit about the academics in this program, the student resources, how to apply for that, the costs involved with it. And then we're going to talk about the shared option of employment and where our students typically go. And then we'll have Joseph talk about the Washington, D.C. campus and everything that's going on with their support for students, their cost, any funding they may have. And then we'll have time for Q&A at the end if anyone hadn't already asked those questions at the start. Went the wrong way. Here we go. So this is a slide I put on all the different webinars, but it's what is the Bush School of Government and Public Service? We are an undergrad and graduate school now here at Texas A&M University. The Bush School now houses the political science department, which has both undergrad classes and a PhD. We also now have the international studies diplomacy track for those students in undergrad. And then the Bush School itself primarily focuses on that master's degree level. So we have 5 degrees here in College Station: Master of International Affairs, a Master of Public Service, a couple of combined degrees with Public Health and Economics. And then we also have 1 executive online degree with an Executive Master of Public Service Administration. There's also 6 graduate certificates. Those are gonna be offered both online and or on campus. And then we've got the 2 DC degrees and the certificate in Advanced International Affairs that's offered there. So we'll go into more detail about the executive level MIP here in College Station and the 2 DC degrees on this webinar today. Essentially, these students are preparing for a career in federal government, state and local government, nonprofits, international NGOs, government contracting, any number of private industry, think tanks, financial institutions. It just runs the gamut. Depends on what the students are interested in, or maybe what they've interacted with their fellow students and find a new path. Maybe it's different than what they thought they would be in. But it's fairly consistent with these types of sectors. So I will cover first off the College Station, Texas. So we're going to cover the Master of International Policy. Now this is an executive level degree. So it is a shorter program. It's meant to get people in and out in 1 year, 30 credit hours, a little shorter than our 48 Master of International Affairs, which typically takes students 2 years. So this degree was built to accommodate some of the military students that were interested in it, some of those that were in the field already and wanted to get in and out a little quicker. So we built this using the same international affairs tracks and concentrations. So if you've been on any of the previous ones when I've listed those tracks, and you'll see those again in a minute, they're the same ones. You just have fewer classes that you need to build from it, but you still have that expansive list of all these courses you can choose from in building it. We do ask that students have to have 4 years of professional international experience related type of background. So we're wanting students to have done something either through the military, maybe through a job they've been working on for a couple of years that had some type of international focus. it doesn't include someone who has gone abroad and done their master's degree in another country and then comes back, because we're not counting that academic credit. It's professional international experience. And if people do have questions on whether they're qualified based off their resume and their experiences, we can provide an email and a resume to our department head, and he can make that justification for you and tell you, yes, I consider all this as to be qualified, or no, sorry, you might want to take a look at our 2-year MIA, or wait a couple of years and then be qualified. We do accept applications for fall, spring, and summer entry. Typically, we're going to have between 5 to 10 students in the fall, and then maybe a handful of students in the spring and summer. Those two options just aren't as popular, but it is an option. There is no internship for this program because the students already have that relevant experience. There's no capstone project they have to work around and build in. And there's no foreign language requirement. Even though we have the resources that you could utilize, you don't have to have that foreign language element in your background in order to graduate like our MIA does. But having said that, there's also no Bush School scholarships. So while we fund the students in the MIA for those 2 years, this is meant to get in and out, and we typically expect students to have their own funding for this. So usually they're going to use their military benefits. Maybe they're sponsored by a foreign country or by the military itself, and we'll help them just get started. And here's what your costs are, but they'll have to work with financial aid and veteran services in order to get all that set up for them. So you can apply for financial aid through Texas A&M for this. There is a little bit of flexibility in this program in that you can take up to 6 hours of electives online. So for some students, that means if they were to come in the fall and the spring, they don't have to be here over the summer. They can go ahead and leave and then take those last two classes, perhaps in the summer online, just realizing that it is a $1,500 more cost for those. That's just the way that the fees work for that. So this is the same as what I focused on for the Master of International Affairs. We have a track and a focus areas. Now for the MIP, there are two tracks you can choose from: international development and economic policy, or national security and diplomacy. And then there are elective areas of study. Now there are no required concentrations like in the MIA. This is just if you're wanting to put together a particular type of focus area, you can choose from these and then choose classes within them to develop that specialty. So you can see there's just a lot of choices here. Diplomacy, cyber, intel, conflict and development, pandemic preparedness, international economics and trade, international NGOs. We have several regional areas in the Middle East, Latin America, China, and Europe. So you can pick and choose as you wish, because you're mainly taking electives. I'm going to show you the sample NSD courses. I pulled a few of these off of our curriculum just to show you every one of those listings that you saw before has at least 6 to 15 classes listed underneath it that you can choose from. Not all are offered every semester, but it still gives you a lot of choice. So you can see some examples I pulled from intelligence, for instance. We've got courses in security law, role of intelligence, terrorism in today's world, transnational security issues, covert actions, analytical trade graph, counterintelligence, defense intelligence, and so on. I couldn't even list all of them on here. Same thing with conflict and development. It's one of those areas that is in the space between development and security. So it works with both tracks. And in that case, those have great famines, war, and humanitarian aid, post-conflict recovery and development. Just a lot of really intriguing classes that you can talk to your fellow colleagues. You can go to the faculty, find out more about those classes, and then sign up for them if interested. There's also the ability here at Texas A&M on our College Station campus that you are on this main campus. We're one of the largest universities in the nation and in the world. So you have an advantage of being able to take electives out of different departments here. So I've already listed a couple of the departments that are featured on our international affairs curriculum. And that could include management information systems, economics, history, nuclear engineering. We've got a non-proliferation for nuclear elements for that. public health, sociology, urban planning. There's just all kinds of options that students can maybe even craft their own focus areas if they don't find one that's exactly what they want out of our listings. The MIP curriculum consists of two core classes, five track classes, which again, those tracks, you can choose anything out of that NSD offerings, and then three additional electives that can be anything. That includes outside of Texas A&M, I said outside of the Bush School at Texas A&M. So semesters one and two, whether it be fall and spring, there's gonna be two required courses with international politics and theory and practice and global economy. And then you'll start taking electives with that. And so you've got three track courses, three electives. And in the summer, again, typically this is how it's done, fall, spring, summer. There's two track courses that are typically offered in summer session one. But if you're off cycle for this, maybe you came in spring, summer, fall, same idea. You can do a couple of those courses in person, or if you choose to do it online, it just costs a little more to do those. So the College Station resources, we have a number of options to help our students. We find that a lot of times the MIP students may not need as many of the leadership program. They may not need the language practice, but there's still resources here. So I've written down a few that I think are more relevant, and that includes the writing program. Students are coming here to be better at their craft, and that does involve their presentations. It does involve their writing and the conciseness and the analytical part of it. And so our writing staff are here to help promote that effective communication. They work with students, they support the faculty courses. You can meet on them with one-on-one to have them go over elements of a paper that you're not understanding what was maybe taken off. They're not here to edit your papers, but they are there for support, and our students do use them. The language practice, remember our Master of International Affairs, that two-year degree, it has a language component where students have to pass a foreign language exam. So we provide them support for it. You don't have to have it, but you can utilize those resources. So we do provide Rosetta Stone free of charge for our students. You just have to indicate, I'm interested in this, and they'll send you the login information for the program of your choice, that language of your choice. And we also have language groups and tutors that you can take advantage of if interested in that. Also, as a large national university, we have speakers and conferences. So there's always faculty, alumni, career sectors coming in and talking about their fields between CIA, defense, intelligence. And so you can attend these events multiple times per week. There's also two major conferences per year that we do hold on this campus. One is Pandemic Policy Initiative, and the other one's the Texas Women Peace and Security Symposium. I believe that latter one is offered usually in November. There are a few international travel opportunities. Not sure if the MIP students would want to do these, but there's usually at least one trip offered in May each year. Past locations have included Germany, Italy, China. There's more. But you just have to see if that works into your schedule. You pay that additional cost. And because of the work that you're doing in preparing for that trip, you would receive a 3-hour course credit for that. And that can be worked into your degree plan. And then finally, I'll just mention the library. Students here have access to A&M's extensive digital and library collection. So that's interlibrary loans, you've got document delivery. We have a Polysciences Economics Library next door to us. So it's easy walking over next door and grabbing those books. You've got 5,000 electronic titles, an open access computer lab, and the librarian right there to help you access those electronic reserves. They're working with our faculty as well. So it is easy to find resources needed to help support your academics here. The research centers and institutes, we've got six of them here, also on the College Station campus, that also helps with bringing in some of those speakers and additionally with the faculty and their research areas that sometimes maybe the students will be hired as student workers to help with certain projects that they're working on. So we've got a few here that I've listed that are international affairs related. That includes the Scowcroft Institute of International Affairs, the Albritton Center for Grad Strategy, Mosbacher Institute for Trade, Economics, and Public Policy, which they're working with the Global Value Chains Program and borders and migration issues. And then you've got the European Union Center. So you can read a little bit more about those on the website. I put a little synopsis on each one. And then there's programs that are tied to our MIA concentration that actually has, there's features on the website, just shows you which faculty are involved in each of these areas and maybe any special projects they're working on. So that includes women, peace and security, intelligence, Middle East, cyber, economic statecraft. So just a lot of options here to support that professional development. So let's get down to the application requirements. So this is similar to what we've had on the other degrees that we offer here in College Station. It is a GradCast application with a fee. There is an unofficial transcripts. The officials are only required if you decide to enroll with us. We only need two letters of rec. Obviously at this level, most of those are coming in for professional. Most are not trying to go back and find academic references at this point. So many times those are military for our students who come in off of that. A professional resume, again, keep that to about 2 pages max. We don't need to know everything that you've done for the last 10 years if you have that experience, but keep it to about 2 pages. Statement of purpose, telling us where you're coming from, what you're interested in studying, what's unique here that you, you know, want to look and study for and prepare for. If your GPA is below a 3.0, the GRE test is encouraged, but it is not necessary. In fact, I don't think anyone who applied or at least were enrolling with us even have a GRE test on file. So I'll give those stats in a little bit. And then English proficiency test scores, we only need those for international students if they've not met that English proficiency in some other way. And those are listed on our website. So a little bit different here is that you're not waiting on us to do interviews and go through that January, February, March. We basically receive an app, and once it's complete, Ashley is working with you directly to get it reviewed by the department head and a committee member or two. And then the turnaround in that is 7 to 14 business days for most. So if you're applying, just remember, we do have spring as an option, and it is that application deadline is October the 15th. So make sure that that is applied if you're interested in this coming spring. Summer entry, we need those by March 15th. And then in the fall, you actually have another month after that, that's April 15th. So our deadlines for this are a little bit later than our MPSA and MIA degrees. All this information is found online on the website under the admissions section in the maroon part of our website, and then just go to the degrees. And then in case you're curious, I always find this interesting just to give this back out. The MIP stats for fall 22 and fall 21. I say fall, but it might include one or two students from either one from summer, there's two from spring. But for 2022, for instance, we had one that came in this summer and four that came in for this fall. And so that's five. I put plus because we potentially have two more coming in for the spring, maybe more. So that average GPA for those students was a 3.46, average age was 30. These were all men that happened to enroll for this fall and summer. There were students of color was 40%, international there was one student, so it was 20%, two non-residents, and of course all of them, it's required for 4 years or more, but usually those students have five or more, and in this case 100% for both classes. So it just shows you the consistency there. This is not meant to be a huge program. It's very integrated with that MIA and that Master of International Affairs here in College Station. We're bringing in about 85 to 90 students. So these MIP students are supplementing that. So even though your cohort may be very small for the MIP, it's actually going to show quite a number of students in your class because there are a lot more than that, obviously. So the professors you're learning from both seasoned practitioners and the academics. And the average class size here in College Station is about 16 because most of our classes max out at 20 students. And then finally, we're gonna cover the cost with a tuition and fees per year. Now remember, we can't help with that non-resident. So if an international student or someone is coming in from outside of Texas, then those are the cost for them. So 1 year tuition and fees, that's the entire program. It's 10 classes. It's about $16,800 for Texas residents. And it's a little over $32,000 for those that are non-residents. And then the cost of living in Bryan College Station is estimated somewhere around that $21,000 yearly. So that gives you an idea for that cost. Just get in and out in those 3 semesters typically. Some students do stretch it out longer if they need to, if they're working and want to. They just work with our faculty and advisors and in the department and let them know that, hey, I need an extra semester. I'm going to just do two classes this time and not. And you've got the freedom to do that because you're not worried about the financial aid of our full-time status of getting our scholarships. You just would have to continue to work with federal financial aid and find out what their limits are. So this is an affordable program because you are saving on a one-year cost. You can apply for outside scholarships. You can work with FAFSA for federal loans. If you have military benefits, yes, it does work with those. And then sometimes you can ask for job financial support. If your company can support you here, if your government, then we work with that too. So finally, the last few things, we're going to talk about this. And Joseph, you can feel free to jump in when you want to comment on it too. But this is shared, right? The Bush School Career Resources, we do have our own staff here in College Station. They do have their staff in DC, but I just wanted to point out a lot of this is overlap of where our students are heading. So I just put this in the middle. So there's three career staff in College Station. There's one in DC who's also working with enrollment, but we've got aspects of employer relations who are bringing in guest speakers. They're bringing in different representatives from agencies from the DC area to come in here and interview our students for intelligence and diplomacy, all kinds of areas, private industry. There's also career programming that we do here in College Station. So we offer workshops for our students. Maybe they're working on their LinkedIn profile and how to make sure that that's up and running to the standards it should be. Maybe it's working on their resumes, their cover letters. There's just all kinds of preparing for an interview. There's also the student affairs element of it and the alumni relations element. So we are a one-stop shop coming in and you can use us the rest of your life. We're here for that master's degree to help you get there. But if someone does change the industries in another couple of years, 10 years down the road, they can come back to us and utilize those resources and maybe reconnecting with some other alumni in an area you're interested in. All of our career staff are assisting with internship and career advising. And then uniquely internships for the NSI students in DC, that you can get credit for those. So I'm going to say INTA department, this is what I was kind of using these for, because again, those numbers for MIP are so small that I really wanted to give a larger number representation. So our international affairs department, which consists of a number of degrees, those employment rates within 6 months of graduation are typically 86 to 95%. It would even be higher, but we end up having to hold a lot of those employment numbers until students clear those security reviews. Those security clearances can take a long time, past 6 months, obviously. And so those numbers do start to increase into the 90s when we go out a year. So 86 to 95%, federal government accounts for about half of our students. That does include the government contracting because many of those are associated with the federal government. Separately from that, we're talking about private industry and the nonprofits. Those are 10 to 20% each year of students going into those fields. And then state and local government, particularly with the MIA program, and continuing education, someone who decides they want to go on for a PhD or a law degree, those often account for less than 10%. Sometimes it's closer to 2%, 5%. But that just gives you a gist that our students are finding careers in these very related fields. And I'm not going to read all of these, but here are some sample career sectors. A lot of this would be in common with what the DC office, because those students are coming in with already experience. It's not like they're trying to switch jobs by and large. Some of them may be, but they are trying to move ahead in their field. And so we're just giving a gamut here of all those three-letter agencies in DC. So just a few of CIA, FBI, US Congress. We've got people working in Congressman's office, either House or Senate, Cyber Command, Defense Intel, FEMA, U.S. Strategic Command, USAID. There's just so many choices. Government contractors, same thing. Deloitte, Lone Star Analysis, Zimatech, which is a USAID contractor. And then we've got the private. I've listed a couple here. And these were all within the last 2 to 3 years of our students. And then state and local government listed a couple. Again, a lot of these are going to be Texas-based because so many of ours are here in College Station. But there's Florida Division of Emergency Management. Somebody went to work with the state of Rhode Island. Nonprofits, you've got some UNICEF Ghana, United Nations Development Program. Students really are working with our faculty very closely to find these jobs that are related to their careers and where they want to be. Okay, I've done a lot of talking. I see William has a question. It says, if you were to apply and get accepted, can you defer to the next semester if needed? William, possibly. When you're talking about the MIP, yes, we can consider that. Because sometimes people come in thinking they're going to start in the fall, and then whatever is happening with their job, their military, just whatever, and they need to roll that over to spring. You just work with Ashley in the admissions process, and we can see about rolling that over. We just have to make sure it works in the system, the department is okay with that, and then yes, we can often do that. Joseph, I don't know if you want to jump in here and answer that as well for yours, but I'm going to mute and let you take over and you can start presenting.
Okay, so I kind of have the same answer as you did. So that's the same thing for us if you do choose to defer. Now I'll get into a little bit about our programs that our degree options that we have here at the Bush School DC. The first is our Master in International Policy. We actually just opened up here at the teaching site in DC in the spring of 2021, so in January, so we're almost on our second full cycle. The MIP, just like in College Station, is a one-year program, 30 credit hours. You do have to have that 4 years of professional international experience, not including, you know, your internship, capstone, and no GRE required. We are currently accepting applications for our upcoming spring semester, summer semester, and for fall 2023 as well. Like we were talking about earlier, the MIP is designed for mid-career working professionals. And what's great, we're gonna talk about this more later, our classes are all offered in the evening. So that way our working folks in DC can be working full-time and then take the classes at night. We have a few different tracks, a few different features in here. Our national security track, have a dozen courses for them to choose between, and up to 6 hours of elective courses can be taken online, as Catherine was talking about earlier, with that additional cost. Then our brand new program that we actually just started this fall semester, which we're super excited about, we just got our first cohort of these students, is our Master in National Security and Intelligence. We just call it NSI, of course, for short. It's a little bit longer program. It's 42 credit hours that opened, like I said, in the fall of 2022. Is designed for early to mid-career professionals. So students just coming out of college might have some experience, but learning, wanting to emerge in their career. We are accepting, just like the MIP, our applications for the spring, summer, and our fall 2023 application. They have a little bit different than the MIP. There is a capstone project, as well as a language requirement to be fulfilled before they graduate. The capstone project can be featured a few different things. Your work with you and the 3 to 4 other students with a federal agency, a congressional office, maybe some think tanks on or a consulting firm here in DC on a problem, help them solve it. Focus, you have a few different focuses or tracks inside of there, the intelligence, national security, and regional studies. The internships for the MIP program are not required, but we do heavily encourage for our students because a lot of them are coming right out of college or mid-career, so that internship can help them find their career afterwards. They can receive, like it says on there, some credit for those internships like we were talking about. We do have scholarships available for our students until, of course, like the funds are exhausted. We do have our Certificate in Advanced International Affairs as well. And it's a shorter program because it's a certificate. So it's only 12 credit hours, and that just opened up for us in the spring. It can complete it online or on campus. So if you take the on-campus courses, of course, it is at night like all the other classes. And more of a concentration where you're interested in what classes you want to take. It's made for working career people who have a little bit flexible only on a short term. But what's great about that, if you do enjoy your time in the classroom as a CAIA student, you can continue on after that into a potential MIP or the NSA. A little bit about actually the location designed for working professionals with evening courses. So our classes actually don't start until 6:30 p.m. They actually used to start at 6, but people informed, our students informed us that parking doesn't open till later. So we moved them till 6:30 so students could be able to park and get there a little bit easier. So we're right downtown. We're only a few blocks actually from the White House. We have ground floor access to the building that we're on, 1620 L Street. We have an on-site library, a student lounge, multiple classrooms and areas for students who are maybe working remote can come work up at the school during the day. I have tons of new faculty and staff. We have a wide variety. I would say wide. We have a practitioner staff, practitioner professors who have worked in the career for a long time in the ICs. And then we have typical academic professors. So we have that wide variety. And we also have tons of opportunities for students to attend conferences, events, trip to different agencies that we have here in the DC area. Like today, we are actually at the Intelligence and National Security Summit. That's where I'm actually at right now. So we have opportunities for students to attend those conferences and things right here in DC. And of course, we have the Aggie Network, which most students might not know this. The Aggie Network has 500,000 alumni. The largest area of alumni, of course, is in Texas. We've been told that the second largest area of alumni is actually here in DC. So we can always find, if you're looking to someone to network with any agency or in Congress, we can always find someone for you up here and everything. Now focus a little bit more on the areas of MIP and DC. So the track for our national security and diplomacy areas of studies can be anything from foreign policy, American diplomacy, intelligence, and then in it, our region studies anywhere from Russia, so the former Soviet Union, East Asia, Middle East. Some of the student resources that we have, we do have our writing consultant that we kind of like Catherine was talking about earlier that can help you out with your academic papers, your professional writings. She is available by appointment. She can do them virtually or in person. She has an office here on campus, as well as we do have an in-house librarian, Alex, who just started with us to help students out. And not only do we have the library here in DC, we have the access to all the digital collections that the Bush School has in College Station and the Texas A&M Library. We also have that, I believe it's the Get It For Me system, so students can access those library books in College Station and have them sent to here in DC. So the MIP that we were talking about earlier, they're all evening classes. They're a little bit different because there's only two required classes and the rest of them are track or elective classes. The courses can be anything from theory and practice of international policy, fundamentals of global economy, 5 national security track courses that they can choose between, and then those 3 elective. The National Security Intelligence, they have actually, like we're talking about earlier, it's a little bit bigger of a program with more credit hours. So they have 6 required core courses, the 4 tracks, and then the 4 electives. They're kind of similar in the American foreign policy, international politics, theory and practice, fundamentals of global economy, the intelligence and security affairs, the research models, and then the research methods, and then the capstone classes. The 4 electives can be taken on any of the intelligence, national security, and the areas and regions of studies with the 4 additional electives as well. So these are some of the sample classes that we will have, like national security law. You guys can kind of read between these. I don't want to sit here and read the whole slide out to you, but these are some of the number of courses that we were offered throughout the fall, spring, and summer semesters. We have a little bit different courses that will be offered during the summer, but we keep a good rotation of our classes in the fall and spring semester. So these are coming up. These top areas are our application deadlines, priority deadlines for the national security or for the master's in international policy, excuse me, and then our NSI degree. So the priority deadlines, so we are still accepting applications for the spring semester. So that is November 1st. So you still have time if you're looking to get in here by the spring. Our summer is April 15th. And then our fall is February 1st, 2023. We do have a rolling application. So we will keep accepting applications from students and admitting them until classes are full. But those are our priority deadlines for our students. It's the same kind of way, the rolling application basis, admissions basis for the certificate. We're accepting students as we get them, but obviously the earlier that you apply, the earlier you can sign up for classes. So these are kind of the requirements for the MIP and the NSI. As you top note, the only difference in the requirements for the MIP and NSI is the MIP does require that 4 years of professional international experience, but the rest is the same for the MIP and NSI. You must submit your application through GradCast, unless, of course, you're a continuing grad student. The application fee, you will all submit this through GradCast. So where you're submitting your application, an unofficial transcript from you. We don't need an official until you actually enroll for classes. Two letters of recommendation, copy your professional resume, your statement of purpose. And as we were talking about earlier with Catherine, her GRE test, that's optional. But we always encourage it if you have a GPA below a 3.0. And then an English language proficiency test. That's for our international students if they have not met that in any other way. So now we're going to kind of break down cost and benefits for us. So we have a locked in rate for tuition fees. It's one flat rate per credit hour, which is $1,300. So it comes out to $3,900 per class that you take. So the MIP is a 10 classes. So it's $3,900 for the MIP program in the NSI. 42 graded hours, so it's about $54,000 for the average cost. That's before any financial aid or scholarships that students can apply for. Cost of living in DC is a little bit more depending on where you live. We have students kind of live all over the DMV. We're a very affordable university here in the DC area. We also have tons of outside scholarships available for students out here. A lot of them, our students are using military benefits as well as their jobs will help pay for their schooling here. So a lot of them who already work in full-time can help them out, as well as, of course, submitting your FAFSA and federal loans and grants.
So at this point, Joseph and I are both done with ours. It was very direct. I don't have necessarily a student to come in. I wish I did, but there's an ongoing talk right now with one of the defense groups here at the lunch hour. And so they're all at that. So at this point, if there's just questions for us, anybody wants to unmute, drop anything else in the chat. I'm going to wait around for just a couple of minutes, see if anything comes in. Otherwise, I'll sign off in a couple of seconds if no one indicates it. And thank you, William, for the comment. We try to make this informative, give you a lot of information, show you how it's a little bit different.
I unmuted here. Can you hear me?
Yes, we good.
I just wanted to again say thank you for this information. I'm sorry, I was driving, or actually in College Station today. But thank you for the information. I really wish I had the ability to take the DC program as well. That just seems very interesting as well. But certainly we'll look into applying for the MIP or MIA in the MPSA.
Okay. Well, if any time you have questions, want to come up here and talk to faculty or set an appointment for that, or visit with either Ashley and myself here in College Station when you're here sometime, you could maybe drop by today if you needed to. We're here to help. So anybody else has any questions, let us know. All right, well, I'll send one more plug. I've got additional webinars coming up. They're gonna be listed on the website under admissions. There's recruitment events. There's a calendar there with them listed. There's also webinars. I've got a drop-in Zoom Q&A tomorrow at 11 for those that have questions about any of our programs. My GA Stockton will be joining me at that time. So you guys just take a look at that calendar, see what's coming up, and we are here to help. Thank you guys so much for dropping in today. And I'm going to sign off now and hope to see you guys in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.